Hi everybody, welcome back to the Den. Today's little review is going to be on the Lepin snow speeder, which is, for those that are having a look, is a clone of the Lego version. I don't have the original Lego version, so I haven't built that one, so I can't say how close it is, but I imagine from building the shuttles that there has been a number of different elements to it, and some other various bits and pieces. Now, she's a big model. At first, I didn't think it was going to come out as big as this, but she is a really nice looking craft. And for those that are iconic Star Wars people will remember back from The Empire Strikes Back. So this is the Luke's one that he brought the AT-AT down with. So really big model. A lot going on. There's a lot to talk about in this before perhaps you want to think about committing to this particular model. So without further ado, let's have a look under the hood and see how she goes. Okay, so here we have, and as you can see, she is a very, very big model. Okay, I'm not too sure what the weight was, and unfortunately the internet went never, if I was going to try and get the piece count, because the manual doesn't actually list the piece count. So let's first of all, as I move this off to one side, let's have a quick look at the quality of the manual. The manual was no problem at all. I've never really had any problems with the Lepin manuals. They'd more than likely be a very good direct clone from the Lego manual. But after listening to some forums and things, they actually shorten a lot of this, so they lessen the pages and do things in quicker steps. So she didn't come with bagged numbers. So although that there is a reference in here for bag one, bag two, etc., etc., but the bags weren't numbered, so we can tell from that this is more than likely a direct clone from Lego's print. Now, we know that we can go online and we can get the manuals downloaded, and I think that's what they've done, is they've just downloaded them and then printed them. So yeah, the manual was great. I didn't have any problems with the manual. The usual bag of extra bits that you get with the Lepin kits, that's all building up quite nicely. Now, there are some bit extra bits in there of mine, actually, and I'll come to the reason why that is as we go through the model. So here she is, the snow speeder, and like I said before, very big model. You can see hand size there. And looking around, she does look the part from a display point of view. She's not overly heavy, so she has whooshability, so you can run around the house with it, pretending you're Luke, bringing down the AT-AT, and always comes with the plaque at the bottom, the UCS type plaque. But of course, theirs isn't Star Wars, theirs is Star Plan. That's their look. So looking over some of the features, swept wings, we have a canopy. Now, one thing I will notice from this is that this model, as opposed to the Lego model, does not come with minifigs. There is no minifigs, the two pilot minifigs, in their kit. So there's no minifigs. And one of those reasons is that when we open up the canopy, the seating area is huge. I mean, it's really meant for a minifig that's double the size of what your normal minifigs is. So, you know, I'm not 100% sure the scale, obviously, when they were looking at this, and I'm assuming that this is as per the Lego one. You know, you put a minifig in there and he'd be absolutely drowned. It's, you know, his head-wise, like I say, it would be double the height for the minifigs. However, some nice decals and stickers for instrumentation, and a little bit of a cockpit area, and the top down as we go in down there. On the rear, we do have engine covers, which I believe in the film were like brakes, so you can actually take off those, pin those back, and see detail inside. And from there, and for some reason, I've yet to just quit, because I just finished it last night, that one doesn't go as high. It's one of those build things where you're looking at it, and you're going, I don't get why it's not going as high. Anyway, and then she just pops off as well. So just put that back in there, because I just forced that open. Anyway, that's one thing I need to just correct on there. So clearly I've either missed something, or we've got a problem. Anyway, it's a minor thing. So we've got those, we've got these edges. Now, one thing I did notice, that in the plans, when you laid out this sort of gun engine thing, I'm assuming it's weapon, but it derives straight from the back of the machine. So, yep. There is a gap which it doesn't show on the plans. It shows that these are all together, but some of these parts actually sit inside each other. And I've tried in different variants, and I didn't get the result. Now, however, in the extras kit, there was two extra light pulley wheels, which you might be able to see in the back there, but that's this component here. And if when planning, it looks as though those component wheels would go on there. However, the brick lugs would stop it from being so high. So, I mean, if you come to build it, you'll see what I mean, but it does leave a gap which isn't on the plans. It doesn't distract from anything, but that's the way it is. Now, there are decals to this set, and I am absolutely pants at putting decals on. It's as simple as that. I would imagine for the cost of the Lego version, which is about £150, £160, that I would imagine that the canopies will be screen printed. That is my feeble, terrible attempt at the stickers. I hate putting stickers on. I went ahead with it on this. I wouldn't normally put them on. I'd leave them off because some of them cover over different bricks and things like that, and it's not going to be up for display forever. So you do have to be fairly good at putting stickers on. So, and whilst I'm probably a 4 out of 10, the fact that I actually got it off the sticker sheet. Okay. One of the other items to it as well was the gun on the back. Now, I was a bit concerned that it's a little bit wobbly, but it's on one of those turntable bricks. So what I did was I put a Lego version of the turntable. I replaced all this element with Lego elements, and I still got the wobble. So there we have it there. One of the things that disappointed me on this particular set was the amount of missing parts. Now, I'm probably talking about 5 or 6 plates, and as you can see on the end here, I don't know how well you can see on the camera, but these should be black single ledge, like they don't have a name, but you know they should be black, and I had to trawl through my collection. Which reminds me, if you are going to buy Lepin, Bella, whatever make abroad, then you've got to be aware that you do need some boxes of parts. And for us that build a lot, I mean, I used to just go out onto eBay and buy up people's old collections of Lego, nothing specific, but it just gave me a nice brick stock to hoof through for components like this. And you know, whilst you are getting it a lot cheaper, please be aware that you may have to compromise with some elements. It wasn't major, but I must say it was a little more than I've been used to on this on these sets. Now, that doesn't mean to say that the people that you buy it from won't replace the items. They will do. But what they like you to do is build the product, list the items, and then they'll post them off to you. And I've done it once and it was great. But you know, when you're building through, you're thinking, well, because some elements you can't complete building if there's one or two small pieces missing. So it's a little bit the only other way round that, if it is a direct clone. And don't forget, the shuttles that I did weren't direct clone. They were not a direct clone. And because of that, even getting a parts list and sitting there and mapping out all the parts to see what before you start the build may not help you. So please be aware of that. So, okay. The stand itself, what would I say generally about this model? Wobbly. I think that sums it up. Some of it just feels wobbly. The stand is, as you can see, look at that. Now, you're going to have to beef that stand up. It's not the end of the world, but please move. It's, you know, this does wobble a bit. This is a fairly heavy, dense piece of kit. The actual subframe underneath was really dense from the build. And there's wobbling around. So, you know, it will sit on the deck, that's fine, but if you are using stand, you have to beef that up. And the other thing is this: they do not make the Lepin version or whatever the Chinese import, do not make those single black pins. They cannot make them. They just have not got the art to make, and hopefully you'll see that on the screen, them, you know, the ones I mean. Okay, and this is the reason why. Look at this. It's wobbling around. I replaced this side with Lego pins, and there we are, that's how it's supposed to be. No wobble around, but their pins are absolutely shocking, to be honest with you. I mean, it's not the end of the world. Once again, if you like buying in these kits, okay, and I do, because I don't collect Star Wars per se, I do have a number of traditional Lego sets I do collect. These are bought in on a whim. I'm not prepared to pay the big money that they want for the big kits. I just wanted it to get a build. It looks nice, it's right. and that it suits my purposes. And on that note, thank you very much for all the abusive comments that everybody sent me in regard to supporting Lepin. I find some of them quite amusing, actually. But anyway, so we've got that situation going on, so that's not saying. So you might want to either source a load more or literally go onto the Lego website and buy a nice couple of big bags of them. You know, sometimes those pins tend to build structures like that, and there we go, you can see the thing. As for the rest of everything, I think she looks a pretty amazing model, very iconic. What would I give it out of 10? Always like to give a mark out of 10. It's one of those, isn't it? It's, I think it's around about, what is it, £60? That's £60-65 with carriage, so it's a good deal on that. And it's another £100 on top of that if you want the Lego version. If you're a Lego collector, fine. If you just want, you know, for your kids to build the iconic ship and you can't afford the other one, which is fair enough, then yes. But be prepared. My main thing is be prepared for some missing parts. Now, I may get through all my other collections and find that's the case. You always get a generous smattering of extra bits. So I think as I go through the kits, I'll probably build up my own extras part. The pins were a letdown. The wobbleness factor was annoying, or is annoying, or still continues to be annoying. But, you know, with a bit of inventiveness, you can beef that up. So it's not the end of the world. But if you are buying this as a one-off kit, you don't really have access to a lot of, you know, a sort of a baseline collection of Lego parts. Then just be wary of that, because that will need beefing up, and you will need to get these extra pins, because that's just annoying. The way it's flopping around there. But a very nice kit. What would I give it out of 10? It's going to be struggling for a 7. Just about hitting the 7 mark for 10 out of 10 for me. There was just some elements I just wasn't happy with. I was, you know, I'd trawled through the bits missing and things like that. So, and it's a shame that they didn't have the minifigs with it either. But like I say, they wouldn't have gone in the cockpit anyway. They would look like Land of the Giants. So, and once again, leaving that up, we don't, once again, when you buy the Lepin, don't forget, you're not going to get the same level of quality of brick. It's as simple as that. They are, what, 90% there, but there is 10%. And one of those things is, in a Lego set, that would have held where it was and not just dropped down. Okay, and so you have that factor as well. But there we are, there we have it. That's the review of the Snow Speeder. And thanks very much for watching. If you're watching now and we're just before Christmas, then please have a happy Christmas. If you're watching between Christmas and New Year, happy, you had a happy Christmas and have a nice New Year. If you're watching in the summertime, bomb out and enjoy the sunshine. So from me and in the den, thanks for watching. Goodbye.